Russia's region of Yakutia sits almost entirely on permafrost, ground that's frozen year-round. Living in a region so cold is fraught with many challenges. But when climate change causes the ground to thaw, those challenges multiply. Julia Chapman reports from eastern Siberia.
Living on permafrost is far from straightforward. The Tajibayevs know that better than most. The lost family left in this lopsided building, they're waiting to be relocated to a new home.
Жизнь продолжается, мы об этом уже и не думаем. Идет криво, но мы уже привыкаем уже к этому же. Привыкаешь, а ежедневные семейные дела у нас вообще.
The collapse came after work was done to insulate the house. The construction contributed to the thaw of permafrost below. It's a process that's accelerating as global temperatures rise. Many houses in towns like Amga are at risk. And the thawing ground has other consequences too.
4 years ago, there was a landslide on the road to Amga, cutting the town off from all land transport for more than a week. The shifting ground is a symptom of thawing permafrost and a sign of just how vulnerable humans are to subtle changes in our environment.
When it's frozen, permafrost is as solid as concrete. So solid, in fact, that pipes can't be laid underground. But Yakutia's summers are getting warmer and longer, with temperatures rising twice as fast as in the rest of the world. Often, buildings have to be propped up to prevent them from caving in. Activists say the government isn't giving the problem enough attention.
Ну, рассматриваются разные варианты, как дальше жить, но тоже науку очень мало финансируют, поэтому пока таких четких, ярких концепций никто не сделал и не видно.
Around 40% of Yakutia is at risk from thawing permafrost. The damage to infrastructure will be expensive. It's expected to cost $67 billion by 2050. So the local government is taking steps to future-proof all new buildings.
У нас есть отдел мониторинга мерзлых грунтов. Отдел занимается у нас сбором информации, систематизацией и материалов, которые мы собираем путем путем геотехнического мониторинга зданий и сооружений. Это делается для того, чтобы оперативно узнавать изменения в вечных мерзлых грунтах, чтобы избежать кое-каких там опасных для жизни граждан.
But those measures won't help many people already living precariously. As Russia makes bolder climate pledges ahead of COP26, Siberia is still waiting for extra support. Julia Chapman, CNA, Yakutia, Russia.